In today's tutorial, I'll show you how you can do a mail merge with attachments. So we're going to be sending personalized emails to multiple people with their own attachments. And we're going to do this from Excel. We're not going to be using any VBA or macros or any external add-ins. Guess what we're using? Did you guess it? Power Automate. Okay, so let me take you through what we're going to be doing here. I have an Excel file called Files Master. In this file, I have a table with each person's first name, last name, email, and the file name that I want to send them. So in this case, it's just the name, not the address of the file. Now notice each person needs to get their own customized PDF document. These PDFs happen to be in the same folder where I have my Excel file, but they don't have to be. They can be on SharePoint, they can be in another folder on your OneDrive. So notice all of these in my case are saved in my OneDrive for Business for now. Let me show you how the PDFs look. The contract for Kim West has her name and her address. The one for Lucas has his name and his address. If you're curious how you can create multiple PDF files from Word, I also have a separate video on that. Check it out if you're interested. In this case, what we want to do is to go to Excel, to select the rows for the people to which we want to send our file to, and then run our flow. What's going to happen is that our flow is going to send each person a customized email message together with their own attachments. All we have to do is select and click. Now let's set this up together. First step is to log into office.com, sign into your account, and then scroll down and go to Power Automate. Now in this case, I want to create a flow from scratch, so I'm going to click on the Create button on the side. Now I have to decide what type of flow do I want to create. What's the trigger? Well, because my trigger is from an Excel file and it's based on the rows that I select, that falls under an instant cloud flow. Because if I scroll down here, notice I have for a selected row as an option. That's the one I want. Now, before I click on create, let's give this flow a name and click on create. Now comes the easy part. I just have to select the location of my Excel file. Mine is in OneDrive for Business. Document library is OneDrive. The file itself, just click on the folder icon and click on these arrows until you find it. Mine is right here. Now comes the table. Well, the moment I click on the dropdown, I get the list of all tables in my Excel file. I just have one table, so I'm going to select that. Now, just to show this to you, let's bring up Excel. That's my data. It's formatted as an Excel table. That's called table files. Okay, so far so good. Now comes the part that we need to think about the next step. So how do we set this up? What I need to happen is somehow to loop through all the files that exist in a folder, check the name of the files, and see if they're equal to the file name that I have specified here. If they are the same, it should grab that file and send it as an attachment. So this means I need the ability to loop through files in a folder. That's an action that's OneDrive related. So let's click on New Step. Search for OneDrive, it's OneDrive for Business, and take a look at the different actions we have. One action is list files in a folder. That's the one we need. This is going to give us an array with information about the files that we have in the folder. All I have to do is select the folder. So this is the folder where my PDF files in this case are sitting in. They're sitting in the contracts folder. Okay, so far so good. Now is the time where we can loop through each of the files in the folder and check whether they match the name of the file that we have in our Excel row. This time I need a control. That control is apply to each because I want to loop. I need an output from my previous step. That's basically the array that I get here. So if I scroll down under dynamic content, I can see value. That's going to do the job. So let's select that. Next is another control. This time, it's a condition. Why a condition? Because I need to cross-check the name with the name that I have in my Excel file. So this time I need to pick this column here, which is called file name. In Power Automate, this is dynamic content. If I scroll down here, I can see the dynamic content connected to my Excel file and I see file name right here. So let's go with that. Next is equal to is fine, but you have different options in case you need them. What is it equal to? Well, it's a dynamic content based on this array here. And of course, I have to make sure that I'm checking the same type of file name. So I can't pick ID or name with that extension. I'm going to go with display name because that way it's identical to the way I've written it in Excel. Okay, so far so good. That's my condition. Next, what do I want to happen if that condition is met? Well, I want to send an email. But before I send an email with my attachment, I need to actually grab that file content that was matched. So as my action, I'm going to get the file content, and this one is OneDrive related as well. So let's just restrict this to the actions we have here. If I scroll down, I see get file content. I need the unique identifier of the file. So if I click inside here under dynamic content, I can see the ID is the unique identifier of the file. So that's the one I need to go with. Next step. Now we can send an email. This one is Outlook related, Outlook 365, and we have send an email. Here I can specify to whom I want to send this email. This, of course, is dynamic content and it's something I have in my Excel file. Email. Click on Add Dynamic Content, scroll down until we get to email. Now for subject, this is something you can make dynamic content as well. So if I had a separate column in my Excel file that was different for each person, I can use dynamic content here. In this case, I don't, so I'm just gonna put your contract. Now you can type in whatever you need in the body. I'm gonna go with hi, and add dynamic content because I have the name of the person in my Excel file. So let's go with first name. And then let's just add some text. Please find attached your file. And we can add dynamic content. This time the dynamic content comes from OneDrive. Let's go with name without extension. And then best regards, Leila. Now we have the email, we have the content, but we don't have the attachment. We're going to find that under advanced options. For attachment name, well, that's simple. If you scroll down, you're going to see name here. Just select that. Attachment content, that's dynamic content as well. It's file content. You can add more attachments in case you need to. In this case, I don't. You can also update the reply to email. You can add yourself on CC if you want or other people. You can also update the from email address in case you need to. Okay, so all of this part is set up. In case there isn't a match between the file names, so basically between the file that I have in the folder and the file name I have in my Excel file, nothing is going to happen because I didn't put anything here. Okay, so far, so good. Let's save this. Okay, so now we're ready to test this. Let's go to OneDrive Online and open our Excel file online. Let me just quickly close the offline version so we're not two people working in the same file. I close that off. Now I just have it open online. Okay, so to run my flow, I'm going to go to the Data tab and click on Flow. In case you don't see Flow here, you need to add it in. Just go to the Insert tab here, go to Office Add-ins, search for Flow and add it. It's a Microsoft add-in and it takes 2 seconds to get this. Once you add it, you're going to find it in the Data tab. So in my case, I've already added it. Once I select it, I see the pane on the side here, and it's going to pick up any flows that are connected to this Excel file. This is my flow. I'm going to click on Run. If it's the first time you're running this, you have to be logged in. You have to have permissions. I'm just going to click on Continue and run the flow. But what would it run? Well, because I just have one cell selected in my table, it's only going to run for this row. If you want it to run for multiple rows, you can select them like this or just select them like this. Now in my case, I want to run it for everything, so I'm going to select these and click on Run Flow. It tells me your flow run successfully started. We can monitor it from the Flow Runs page, so click on Done. Now before we check our flow run, let's just make sure everything worked. So one of these emails is this one, and they should have received contract.kimwest.pdf. I guess I'm going to open up Outlook, and I can see your contract is here. Hi Kim, please find attached your file, contract Kim West, best regards Leila. That's the contract. When I open it, it's their own custom PDF. Now you can check your flow run either from here, or we can go back to Power Automate and check our flow run here. So I'm just going to go back. I can see information about my flow up here, and I can see all my flow runs succeeded. Okay, so that's a super easy way to send customized attachments to different people directly from your Excel file.
You see, that's the power of Power Automate. It allows us to do tasks that we needed to use external add-ins for. Now we can create those add-ins ourselves as we need them. That wraps up today's tutorial. I hope you found it useful. Let me know in the comments if you're using Power Automate or not. If you are using it, give us some examples to encourage us, to give us ideas. And if you aren't using it, can you see yourself using it? Are there tasks or processes that you think you can use it for? Please do share. Thank you for watching. Do consider subscribing in case you aren't subscribed already. And I'm going to see you in the next video.